fresh as you can get!
God be with you.
I'd like to learn to read.
You? You don't look like the makings of a priest or clerk. But why not? I've taught all sorts. Bear in mind, it won't be all that easy. You'll need plenty of time and a few groschen for my trouble.
All right. I don't want to waste time. We can get started. The sooner I master it, the better.
Very well. I will require some groschen from you, though, and set aside at least a couple of days so I can put you through your paces, if indeed time is of the essence.
Here are your groschen.
Then we may as well start.
He did break his vow. But better than to dishonor it here. May he follow his heart.
Wake up, lad. It's time we were getting on. So, let's see you read a bit. There's a book here on the table. Try to read it.
Will I manage?
You ought to be able to. It's a simple text. Come back once you've worked your way through it. Whoa.
Radishes, carrots, and apples, that'll put a smile on your face. Free to have a knock.
Thank you.
I've read the book.
Wonderful. So tell me, what have you learned?
There was something about some fellow and a goose.
Ah, well, the main thing is you've managed to read the book. The rest is just practice. Only through a careful reading will you uncover the real meaning of the text. No book is written on a mere whim and without purpose. Like I told you, books are valuable. And the words that you place in them ought to be no less so.
Does that mean that I can read then?
Yes, you have the foundation. Remember, my boy, the pen is mightier than the sword. To fully learn your way around words will take a lot more reading yet. Now we'll move on to the second lesson, which will be much harder. Many books are written in Latin, the language of erudite and religious men. If you really want to be able to read, there's no getting away from Latin. There's a book on the table with some text. Read it and then come back. You need not understand it, but you should master the letters.
I only just managed the fable about the goose, and now you're asking me to tackle Latin.
You're a clever lad. You'll manage.
I read the page.
So tell me, Distrupule, what's written there?
Nullus est liber tam malus, ut non aliquae parte prosit.
Good heavens! Don't tell me you haven't had lessons before. Excellent. Well, there's nothing more I can teach you. Congratulations. You can go and be ordained right away.
Thank you, Domine. I'm feeling a lot wiser.
God be with you.
God be with you.
Ugh.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Well, we can try it. Aye, that would do it.
To heal, Mutt.
Good boy. That's my boy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. 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 Wait a moment. You're him, right? The boy from Scarlet's?
Wait a moment. You're the young fellow who came here from Scarlet's, half dead, aren't you?
Yes, that'll be me. Why?
The lady of the castle was asking after you. She wants to talk to you.
Ah, I'll go and see her then. Thank you.
Very well. Don't make her wait. Good luck to you.
Yeah.
What are you doing here?
Why do you ask? Can I not take a walk in the woods without being accosted?
I ask because I'm the gamekeeper here, and it's my job to protect these woods from poachers.
Well, I'm certainly not poaching.
In that case, you won't mind if I have a look what you've got on you.
Not a chance. You're not going to rummage around in my things.
That's as good as a confession to me. You'll come with me to the jailhouse.
And what if I don't go?
Then I'll make you.
Try it. Get him!
Come here!
Take your hardware and get the hell out of my sight.
All right, all right. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good health to you.
I've done as you asked.
Excellent, Henry. I look forward to the latest news from Talmberg. I hope Captain Robart rubs the commander's nose right in it.
I've got some goods here whose owners might miss them.
All right. Let's see what we can do about that. See you later.
I've got some goods here.
All right. May the Lord watch over you.
Have you got any more jobs for me?
Of course. You're just in time. I could do with a horse, and since I'm setting the task, I'll go further. I'd like a strong stallion direct from the Murhoyed stables.
Now that's no mean feat you're asking.
As well I know. And well I'll pay.
I'll steal that horse for you, but the reward had better be worth it.
Don't worry. But you'd best not come back with some old nag.
Take care now.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
My respects to you.
Aren't you Ringlet? Milan says I have to beat you before he'll take me on.
And you're that blacksmith's lad, right? What do you want out of it? You're not living in the dirt here like the rest of us.
Maybe not. But why shouldn't I try and beat some coin out of him too?
Yeah, and you can pass it on to us that need it. If you want to fight me, you dandy, then pay up or fuck off.
Good luck to you.
God be with you.
Let's fight.
I told you, Don't come back to me till you've beaten Stephan and Ringlet. Got it? Take care now.
Yeah.
Good day to you. What do you need?
You're Stephan, aren't you? Milan tells me he won't fight me until I beat you.
Oh, yeah? And why would you want to? Well, never mind. I'll fight you if you pay me. What do you say?
God be with you.
Let's fight.
You gave those two a pretty good hiding. And I made a groschen or two in bets. You Scalitz fellows are good for my purse. Good luck to you.
Hey, good health to you.
You've an honest trade.
How come you got mixed up in crime?
Evil times. The harvest failed, and there was no grain to mill, and a child to feed on top of it all. I had no choice. And meanwhile, the lords in the castle and the monks in the monastery stuffed their craws to bursting. Where's the justice in that?
So you took justice into your own hands, is that it? And now you take whatever you need?
Pull your head out of your ass, Henry, and take a good look around you. Wars come and go, but nothing really changes. It's the poor that do the dying, and the nobles who reap the rewards. We have to survive somehow, so why concern ourselves with morals?
Would you happen to have any work for me?
Of course I would. And, surprise, surprise, it's another ring.
Like last time.
Properly done this time. Proper hard work. And who else to set the task to than you? The ring leader, so to speak. The thing is, one of the rich townsmen left his ring behind the last time he went to the baths for some wenching. Too drunk to see it, no doubt. And now he wants it back, and the baths deny all knowledge.
Why not turn to the bailiff?
Why not? Because he doesn't want anyone to know about his bathhouse visits. And the girls in the baths are wary of selling the ring in case the bailiff does start looking for it after all. So we'll make life easier for them. What do you say?
Consider it done. Provided I get something out of it.
Don't worry. You won't be left short. The ring's hidden in the chest in the bathhouse madam's chambers. Come right back with it once you have it.
I'll see you later.
Look at you, lover boy.
What now? Shall we take a walk?
You don't give up, do you?
Well, let me think. And where would you care to go?
What if we took a stroll along the river?
Why not? That sounds lovely. Shall we go?
Let's go.
It was a good idea to go for a walk. Not that I don't like the mill, but you get tired of it. So I'm glad you took me out. I'd love to see the markets in Prague one day. Have you ever been to Prague?
No, I haven't. I have been in Kuttenberg, but Prague must be much bigger.
I've heard it's pretty smelly, though.
Yeah, so many people in one place. So many assholes.
It's disgusting. I love to listen to that young preacher, Jan Hus. They say he preaches in the common tongue. Everyone's talking about it.
I bet he's just handsome. That's why the women dote on him.
You're a right one. A preacher doesn't need good looks for people to listen to him.
And what about that fine fellow at St. James? I know full well why all the girls have started going to confession, and you have too, so don't give me any of that.
You scoundrel. Well, all right. I admit I find him handsome. But that doesn't make me a bad Christian.
I'd never dare to suggest such a thing.
Tell you what. Let's not dawdle. Last one is a slimy slug. Was fun. Sit down here next to me, Hal. And what about you? I heard you're helping Sir Radzig.
Sir Radzig has me running in a few errands. I have to say, he always treats me well, and I make a wage.
So you've had your turn of luck. What's it like serving nobility?
Oh, it's endless luxury, money, banquets, games stuffed with other games.
A chicken stuffed with a frog?
Yeah, and that's nothing compared to a frog stuffed with a chicken.
A goat stuffed...
with a pig? Now then.
Oh, Henry, what am I going to do with you? Wandering the land, turning innocent girls' heads.
The only one here whose head is all messed up is me. How do you always manage to look so good?
Just look at the lady killer. Where did you learn to talk that way?
I don't recall which church service it was exactly.
You scoundrel. But you certainly know how to make a girl feel special. You may continue. But now I have to go.
Can I go with you?
Just a little way. I don't want anyone to gossip. Thank you for coming with me. Please come and see me again.